Hi, seventh grade math students. This is Mrs. Aldous teaching you a little bit from home. Last week, this packet was made available through the district. You were able to pick it up at the elementary schools or wherever lunches were being passed out. I also attached it in Google Classroom and sent it home to your parents. There's a lot of information in here that we're not going to get to all of it, but keep this. We might come back to it later in the school year. I would like you now to turn to page 7, which is the, I assigned problems on page 7 and problems on page 8. And we are going to just do a couple problems here together. Pretty much everything we're going to do from home like this is going to be review of important 7th grade content that we did learn earlier in the year. So if you remember, when we multiply a negative times a negative, we end up with a positive. And I don't know if I showed it to you, but there's a great, really quick visual where you can put a triangle with a plus sign at the top and two negatives on each side. And this uses a quick cover-up to help you remember the rules. So if I multiply a positive times a negative, I end up with a negative. And if I cover up the positive and I cover up a negative, I'm left with a negative. That means the answer to this is going to be negative. And then I just use regular multiplication. 3 times 7 is 21. The same works with this triangle if I have a negative times a negative. So let's skip down to this one. Negative 1 times negative 7. So I'm going to cover up the negative, and I'm going to cover up a negative. What's left is a positive, reminding me that when I'm multiplying two negatives, I end up with a positive. So the answer to this is just 7. So down here, there's some similar problems, but there's some where instead of just two numbers, we're multiplying three. So let's do this one together. Negative 1 times positive 2 times negative 6. And I'm going to use this workspace down below to rewrite it. Negative 1 times positive 2 times negative 6. Now this says explain how you determine the sign of the product, but if you're showing your work, you don't need to write a written explanation. Negative 1 times positive 2. If I go back up to my triangle, I've got a negative times a positive, so I'm going to end up with a negative. 1 times 2 is 2, so this is negative 2 times negative 6. Now I have a negative times a negative. Negative times negative is a positive. And 2 times 6 is 12. So the answer to this is 12. I'd like you to try to work the rest of the problems on this page. And then on page 8, they're just a little bit more challenging because it's bringing in the distributive property, which we worked on just a couple of months ago, where we share things. So negative 6 times negative 3 plus negative 6 times 3 is equal to negative 6 times negative 3 plus 3. So they've taken this first step and they've said if both of these are multiplied by negative 6, then I can undistribute them and show that negative 6 is times negative 3 plus 3. Then you do what's in the parentheses. Remember when we've talked about PEMDAS? Negative 3 plus 3 is going to be what? So I would end up rewriting this as negative 6 times 0. And negative 6 times 0, anything times 0 is 0. So try to find the mistake that's made in this work and then see if you can show how to do the problem correctly. I will add to our post on Friday with the answers to these problems. Starting next week, you're going to have a packet from me and the other 7th grade math teachers that takes us back to Agile Mind. If I will be putting some Agile Mind assignments in Agile Mind, it's all review. It goes back to the second unit of the year. We will also be going back to these packets that I passed out right before we left school. And if you weren't there, then this got mailed to your house. We're only going to be doing two problems a day. If you recall, this is just set up with four problems each day. I'm not sure if we'll do four every day, but we're going to use this like we would have used these at school this spring as a warm-up activity. This would have been our do now. So we'll use it similar to that. So we're going to go back to what feels like normal, but most of the content is going to be things that we learned in school before we left, with this acting like a do now, and then you will have a packet that looks a little bit more familiar than this, that is pages out of our Agile Mind books, and you can pick those up wherever they're distributing food, and I will also post those on Google Classroom. All right, see you guys soon.